We have always prayed together. Because right from the onset, when he was transferred to Bukwa District Local Government, he has been telling me, I have challenges at my workplace.
Slain Bukwa Cow, Robert Charles Ogwang's widow says she told him to leave the job when he confided in her about the challenges he was facing, but he insisted on serving. Evelyn Apio says her husband asked her to pray for him.
Then that Sunday, I told him, my husband, suppose you leave this job, I would like you to get it clearly from me. Suppose you leave this job and you come and stay home. Do you think we are going to die? Then his response was, my dear wife, let me go, but keep praying for me.
Apio describes her husband as a God-fearing person, transparent and not corrupt.
He has worked in all these districts of Apach, Oyam, Yumbe, Kitgum, Arua, with very clear records. So is it true that it is only Bukwa where he failed to manage?
Apio narrates that on the day Ogwang died, he called her at 10 a.m. to tell her he was traveling to the ministry to handle the issue of the budget, and they prayed together. At 8 p.m., he called again to inform her that he was leaving Kampala and traveling to Lira to see her and the children. She asked if he was coming with a driver, but he said the driver had already left for Bukwa and she wished him a safe journey. At 11 p.m., she received a call from a person who identified himself as a Good Samaritan, who informed her that her husband had been shot.
So, as Good Samaritans, there were two, a lady and a gentleman, and they didn't mention their details. So they picked him and rushed him to Hospital.
Apio says a doctor at Bombo called her and he told her that the victim was bleeding, but there was no blood at the facility.
They tried to manage, but they failed. Then at 4 a.m., I was called only to receive the bad news.
Brutality exhibited in the killing of late Robert Charles denied him an opportunity to be confirmed as a substantive chief administrative officer. And we are putting the Minister of Local Government to task to make sure that Robert Charles is promoted to a substantive chief administrative officer.
Geoffrey Ogwal, the Kwania district chairperson, described Ogwang as a person who did not tolerate corruption. He challenges the government to catch the killers.
I come in contact with the lady, we refer to him as Get Going, when he was a teacher in Adufu Secondary School. Get Going is a person I know, I think part of his behavior contributed to his death. Because he's a person who does not tolerate nonsense. He's a man who does not tolerate corruption. He's a man who will always tell you the truth. He's an extrovert. And partly must have caused him the death.
Sam Atul, the mayor of Lira City, described Ogwang as a persistent, focused, and resilient person.
I stand here to speak about Robert Charles Ogwang that I got to know way back in 1995 when I joined NDC NETA.
Before his death, we shared with him when I met him also servicing his vehicle at Gaz petrol station. He was telling me how he was living in Bukwa, and if I can remember, my advice to him was like, talk to the PS, leave the place, those people will kill you.
It is true that there are some conflicts somewhere, as the organization did, but not all people in Bukwa hated Ogwang.
The whole of northern Uganda has been darkened when we received this information that our brother was murdered in a very brutal way.
Report by Hudson Apunyo for the news.
Mr. Chairpersons.